Hi, this presentation is going to discuss probability distributions. We'll begin this discussion by defining a random variable, which is a numerical value associated with each outcome of a probability distribution that may be discrete or continuous, and a continuous variable is one with finite or countable number of options, while continuous has an uncountable infinite number. Here are a couple of examples. First, the distance your car travels on a tank of gas is a continuous variable because that can be fractional and not necessarily just whole numbers. However, the number of students in a statistics class is certainly a discrete variable, as you can't have a fraction of a student. So if we go to discrete probability distributions, these apply to discrete variables. And as we see here, they have two conditions or two properties. The probability of each value is between 0 and 1, and the sum of all probability is 1. And these are the symbols that represent those statements. If we wish to construct a discrete probability distribution, the following are the guidelines. If x is a discrete random variable with possible outcomes represented by these subscripts x, then the first step is to make a frequency distribution of all the possible outcomes. So if there are four outcomes, for instance, we would make a frequency distribution for those four outcomes. We find the sum of the frequencies across those classes, and we find the probability of each possible outcome by dividing its frequency by the sum of the frequency. And finally, check that each probability is between 0 and 1 and that it all sums up to 1. So in this simple example, we just have two possible outcomes on a spinner. You could see that the probability of getting a 2 is about 75%, while getting a 1 is 25%. And there is the distribution, frequency distribution, along with the probability of each. And you add those together, it sums to 1, and that's what we're looking for. If we extend that example to two spins, then the probability of landing on the 1 is still 0.25, and the probability is still 0.75 of landing on the 2. But now we're spinning it twice, so let x be the sum of the two spins. And if we construct a probability distribution for this with two spins, then the possible sums are 2, which would be landing on 1 twice, 3, which would be landing on 1 and then 2, and 4, which would be landing on 2 twice. And so the probability of the sum of the two comes to 0.25 times 0.25. Spin a 1 on the first is 0.25, and spin a 1 on the second. So the chances of getting the 2 as a total are 0.0625. And continuing on, the probability of getting a 3 as a 1 and a 2, which is 0.25 times 0.75, and the probability of that, therefore, is the product of that, 0.1875. And finally, the probability of getting 3, the other way around, would be the same, of course, now that just reversing the order. We'll go to one more possibility on the next slide, and that's, of course, the probability of getting 4, and that's getting a 2 twice. And the probability of getting a 2, as we know, is 0.75, so multiplying those will give us 0.5625. So the greatest probability with a spin, two spins of the spinner is that we'll get two twos, and that's going to happen a little better than half the time. And now that we've figured out the probability of all the combinations, we can construct our frequency distribution 2, 3, and 4 along with the probability of each. And if you add those together, of course, that fulfills what we expect, and that is 1. If we wish to display the frequency distribution graphically, we could do so with this discrete probability distribution graph, which is a histogram, and there's the probability by the outcome. Next, we can find the mean of a discrete random variable given by this equation. Mu is the sum of x times p of x, which is the probability of x. And so if we go down and we simply multiply the outcome by the probability for each of the outcomes and their associated probabilities, and then we can sum those together, we get the sum of x of times p of x is 3.5. So the mean for the two spins is 3.5. We can also find the variance of a discrete random variable through this equation. Sigma squared is the sum of x minus mu squared, which is the deviation squared, so the squared deviations, times the probability. And so we can do that down here. If we do so, we find that the variance of this particular distribution is 0.376. If we wanted to find the standard deviation, we know that's simply the square root of the variance. So 0.376, take the square root, 0.613. And finding the mean is an important step because that is what tells us what our expected value is going to be. So if we had to place a bet on what we thought would be the best potential outcome, that would be the expected value, and that is the mean of the distribution. So the expected value is simply mu, or the sum of x times p of x. Here's an example. If we have a raffle, 500 tickets, each sold for $1 for two prizes of $150 separately, what is the expected value of your gain? You win a $100 prize is 100 minus 1. You gain a $50 prize is 50 minus 1 because it costs $1 to buy. So your gain is the prize minus the cost. So now we're going to write a probability distribution for this example. And the expected value for the raffle, the $99 is 1 out of 500. The $49 also 1 out of 500. And then the chance of losing $1, 498 out of 500. And so given that, we know that we can multiply these and add them together. And that's going to give us the mean of the distribution, which is our expected value. All right. And in this case, that works out to a loss of 70 cents. So we expect to lose 70 cents by entering into the raffle.